وللمزيد حول الاقتصاد الإماراتي تنضم إلي في الاستوديو السيدة ختيجة حقي، رئيسة قسم بحوث الشرق الأوسط وشمال أفريقيا في بنك الإمارات دبي الوطني. ختيجة، أهلا وسهلا بك مجددا في البرنامج. على مدى عقد فائت، كيف تبلور شكل الاقتصاد الإماراتي وكيف كان النمو فيه؟
So over the last 10 years, most of the economies in the region, including the UAE, have made quite big efforts to diversify away from oil and develop the non-oil sectors. What we saw in the first part of the decade, so 2012 through, say, 2015, was relatively high growth rates, I'd say 4 to 5% per year. For the UAE's non-oil sectors. However, what we had in 2014, 15, 16 was a significant drop in the oil price, which then forced governments in the region to reassess how they were running their budgets and where they were spending money, and to try and rationalize and put their budgets on a more sustainable path. And what that meant was cutbacks in government spending, some of them quite significant. And so what we've seen over the last 4 or 5 years, so from 2016 through to 2019, is a significant slowdown in the rate of growth in the UAE's non-oil sectors. So we haven't gone into recession. The economy has continued to grow, but the growth rate has been much slower than we saw in the first part of the decade.
خديجة، هناك حديث عن طفرة في النمو في 2020 يتم ربطها بإكسبو 2020. ما هي نظرتك؟
So we do expect the non-oil sectors to benefit from the expo, and we're expecting that to come in the form of a growth in tourism numbers. So 2018, we didn't see much growth at all in the number of international visitors coming to Dubai, but this year we have seen that recover quite nicely. So if I look at the data through November, it's around a 5% growth in the number of people coming to Dubai on holiday, and the expectation is that that number will rise again in 2020. And what that means is that you have a recovery in demand for hotel rooms, you have people eating at restaurants, you've got people shopping at the malls, going to use the different services and entertainment facilities that are available. And so that is hopefully going to provide a boost across a number of sectors in Dubai's economy, which I think could really use the boost next year or this year now.
هل يمكن القول بأنه في 2021 بعد انقضاء الإكسبو ستعود بعض التحديات التي نعيشها اليوم للظهور على السطح، وماذا تقتضي من سياسات للمعالجة برأيك؟
I think that's a very big concern because clearly if you are relying on tourism to support the broader economy, then those people will need to keep coming every year in order to provide that boost to activity. So I think, you know, what we've seen is that real estate and construction over the last 2 years, as Dubai has been preparing for Expo, those have been big drivers of growth in Dubai's economy. Obviously, that is now slowing. That Expo is here. Most of the big projects are completed. And so looking ahead, what is going to be the driver beyond tourism for Dubai's growth? And I think the key question to look at is where are the jobs going to be created? If we look at Dubai and the UAE as a whole, the majority of the population actually comes from somewhere else. So in order to generate population growth, you need to create jobs for people to come and do. And if you do that, then you would be creating demand for the supply that's being brought online. So you have people coming in to live in the homes that have been built, to shop in the malls, to use services. Without that increase in population, which will have to be driven by job creation, then you're going to continue to have excess supply, and that is going to keep prices down, whether it's in the real estate sector, whether it's in the retail sector, or in the hospitality sector as well. So I think the focus for the next 10 years needs to be job creation, not just in the public sector, but in the private sector to attract people to come and live here from other places.
وعندما نتحرك عن تحدي خلق الوظائف وتعظيم الأعمال على مدى السنوات المقبلة، هل نحن نتحدث عن نفس القطاعات الكلاسيكية التي قام عليها الاقتصاد تقليديا، أم أننا نتحدث أيضا عن إضافة عدد من الاقتصادات، اقتصادات الجديدة اللي يقال عنها؟
I think you can absolutely look at new ways to grow the economy. So I know there's been a huge amount of focus that's been put on technology, innovation and all of that new stuff that's being developed. And I know that the UAE wants to be a hub for those industries, and I think that's a great idea. But at the moment, those industries are not big enough to drive enough growth for the whole economy. So I don't think you can ignore the traditional sectors like manufacturing, like retail, like transport and logistics. Those have been the engines of not just Dubai, but the whole UAE's non-oil story. And so if you're looking at, you know, that is the chunk of the economy, you have to also see growth in those sectors in order for everything to benefit. So yes, certainly there will probably be some small new sectors which will grow at a much faster rate. But if you want to see a benefit that's widespread overall, then you do need to still have growth in the traditional sectors as well. And I think the government also needs to bear that in mind when they're putting together their economic plans, is that you can't ignore manufacturing, you can't ignore retail, you can't ignore trade. You have to provide support for all of those sectors.
خديجة حقي رئيسة قسم بحوث الشرق الأوسط وشمال أفريقيا في بنك الإمارات دبي الوطني، شكرا جزيلا لك.